Transmission and Distribution Systems, Part 2C, Transmission Line Model and Representation. This is the third part of Topic 2 in the series of Transmission and Distribution Systems. So, in the previous part, we discussed about overhead and underground distribution systems. And just to give a glimpse of what's ahead is Transmission Line Parameters, Capacitance Part 2D. Transmission line parameters, induction, admittance, and conductance in Part 2E. So in this part, we will be discussing transmission line models and representations. Let's start by discussing the line constants and their effect on the power system. Then we will describe how transmission lines can be modeled. Transmission lines have three important parameters or constants that are resistance, inductance, and capacitance. These constants are important because the supply voltage, current, transmission line efficiency, and line losses depend on these parameters. Power factor mainly depends on the value of inductance and capacitance, whereas power loss or copper loss depends on the value of resistance in transmission line. We will discuss these in upcoming parts 2D2E and 2F. It is important to determine and model these parameters to better understand the power system. Therefore, transmission lines are commonly classified in three ways: short transmission line, medium transmission line, and long transmission line.
Hello everyone, Abdurrahman here from AllumiaX Engineering. To learn more and to continue sharpening your technical skills, visit our website at AllumiaX.com/learn.
We shall start our discussion from short transmission line. The diagram here represents a short transmission line, which connects a generator and load. Here IS and VS are the sending end, current, and voltage, while IR and VR are receiving end current and voltage respectively. Transmission lines, which are up to 50 miles, 80 kilometers in length, and have voltage less than 20 kV, may be represented as short transmission lines. The resistance R and inductance L are considered to be evenly distributed along the line, shown as series impedance Z. Shunt capacitance, although present, is so small that it is considered negligible and omitted without much effect on accuracy. This makes it easier to understand and model short lines. Next, we have medium transmission line. Transmission lines, which are roughly between 80 kilometers to 240 kilometers long, and with voltage between 20 kV to 100 kV, are classified as medium transmission line. Due to high voltage and longer length, the effect of shunt capacitance C can no longer be ignored, as previously done. Resistance R and inductance L are evenly distributed along the medium line, just as modeled in the previous short line.
As you're watching this video, we hope you find it useful and engaging. GeneralPAC creates video tutorials so people like you can learn about power systems easily and efficiently. So become our patron, get exclusive perks, and we can't wait to see you on the other side.
Now, there may be two ways to represent the shunt capacitance. Half of the total capacitance is lumped at both ends of equivalent model of transmission line in the nominal Pi modeling of medium transmission line, or the capacitance may be lumped at the center of medium transmission line. In the T model, we will explain the nominal P and nominal T model of medium transmission line now. Nominal Pi model. As we have previously mentioned, the medium transmission line can be modeled as nominal Pi model, in which the series impedance, resistance plus inductance, is placed at the center of line, whereas one half of the capacitance between phase and neutral is lumped at each end of line, which is shown as the shunt admittance Y in the diagram. After solving for sending end voltage VS and current IS using KVL and KCL methods, we end up with generalized circuit constants A, B, C, and D. That is, A is equals to D is equals to Z times Y over 2 plus 1. B equals to Z. C equals to Y times of bracket open, 1 plus Z times of Y over 4 bracket closed plus 1. The sending end voltage and current are given by VS equals to VR times A plus or times B. IS is equals to IR times D plus VR times C. Next, we have the nominal T model. Moving forward, we have nominal T model representation of medium line. Here we divide the series impedance, resistance plus inductance, in two equal parts, but the shunt admittance is concentrated in the center of circuit.
The series impedance divided into two parts, and shunt admittance between line and neutral,
virtually make a
T and hence T model, is the name given to this representation.
The sending end voltage is the source voltage or the voltage at starting end of the transmission line, and the sending end current is the source current or the current at the starting end of the transmission line. Both of these are largely dependent on inductive and capacitive reactance of the transmission line.
Here we again use KVL and KCL to find the generalized circuit constants
A, B, C, and D. And then we are able to write general equations to find sending end voltage and current of medium line using nominal T model. The constants are A is equals to D is equals to Z times Y over 2 plus 1. B is equals to Z times of 1 plus Z times of Y over 4. C is equals to Y. The sending end voltage and current are given by Vs equals to Vr times A plus Ir times B. Is equals Ir times D plus Vr times C. Long transmission line. Moving on, we have transmission lines which are longer than 240 kilometers and have a line voltage higher than 100
kV.
They are modeled as long transmission lines. The effect of shunt capacitance is even greater in long transmission lines due to very high voltage. The constants R, L, and C are now distributed uniformly throughout the transmission line. For the modeling of long transmission line, the method used is known as rigorous method. We cannot use lumped parameters in the case of long transmission line since serious errors can occur. Hence, we use distributed parameters for long transmission line modeling because it is not practical to lump such high values reactants that are present in long transmission line, unlike short and medium lines. The line constants are distributed evenly over the whole transmission line. The inductance and resistance form the series elements, whereas leakage susceptance, B, and leakage conductance, G, are shunt elements. All the energy losses due to corona effect are accounted for as the leakage conductance and the admittance is given by Y is equal to the square root of G square plus B square. By using rigorous method, we can derive equations for source voltage and source current. These are given by derivations are omitted for simplicity. Vs is equal to Vr times of cosh hyperbola, a square root, Y times Z added with IR times of square root Z over Y multiplied with sin hypola square root Y times Z. IS is equal to VR times of square root Y over Z multiplied with sin hyperbola square root Y times Z added with IR times of cos hyperbola of square root Y times Z, where Y is total shunt admittance of the line. Z is total series impedance of the line. So, for detailed derivations and calculations, you can refer to Chapter 10 of Principles of Power Systems by V.K. Mehta. We hope that you have gained valuable insights of this topic and series. We also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. So, in the next video, we will study transmission line parameters, capacitance. Please support us by subscribing to GeneralPAC.com and becoming a patron on Patreon.com. GeneralPAC.com is making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Thank you.